September.
Oh, precious September to remember. Shabaya.
Amen.
September to remember.
Amen.
That's a very powerful word. Amen. So the one we'll be looking into, as I usually do, when we have theme, then we'll have a topic for each day, by the grace of God, we'll be looking into something very important, just to open up some things, you know, to start with that, and see how God takes us. Amen.
Amen.
You know, let me use that word. What are the reasons why September must be remembered? What are the factors? I want to start with that, just to open our eyes to some things. Because the question is, why are we remembering September? What is so special about September? I don't know if you ever you asked that question. When you saw that thing, September to remember, like, what is special about September? You know, why not December? Why not January? Why September? You know I mean? Of all months.
It's 9 months. Huh?
A month to deliver.
Okay,
that's
a good one. That's a good one. Amen, that's a good one. Yeah, that's a powerful one right there. Ninth month, the life cycle, the month of a life cycle. Ninth month, it's always in, you know, when new life comes in. You know, so when we look at the major reasons why September is, you know, is fit to be remembered. That will be our focus, and then if God permits, we'll go to other things, but and then I want to pray for us, because if September is not handled very well, it will affect October, November, and December. So September is like a window, a portal. So when you handle September very well, then October will respond. November will respond. And then December will respond. Amen. Why? Because of what I call, you know, historic reason and prophetic reasons. Historic and prophetic. So today's going to be like a kind of introduction. Amen.
Amen.
Historic and prophetic reasons why September should remember. Okay, let's go really quickly. One, you know, the general, you know, I call it global stronghold evil quarter of the year. September, October, November, December, the last quarter of the year, Ember Month, they call it Ember Month. So listen very carefully, I want to build my case. Number one, why we must remember September? Number one, so that we can deal or handle the global stronghold. How about this Ember Month, Ember Month, Ember Month? Because if you don't handle it, then it will be opening up October, November, December to an attack. So handle it as you come into the portal, the window of this Ember Month, which is September. The September opens it up, opens the Ember Month, the last quarter of the year. So for us to handle it and deal with this price, you know, very squarely, so it will affect our October, November, December. And as we pray during this 3-day dry fast, every force trying to affect your last quarter of the year is hereby destroyed.
Amen.
Is hereby destroyed.
Amen.
In the name of Jesus.
Amen.
As you handle this September, October will be easy.
Amen.
November will be easy.
Amen.
And December will be easy.
Amen.
In the mighty name of Jesus.
Amen.
So want to handle the stronghold of this quarterly, or this quarter, last quarter of the year, called the Ember Month. Two, remember what happened in 9/11. Happened, right? Where did it happen? What month did it happen?
Yes.
September 9/11. Yeah, 9/11, that was about 9/11. And you know, America is in the bigger picture of the heartbeat of God. What God is doing in our time. Remember, it was United Nations that declared the return to town, declaring that Jewish had the right to own a land, have a place, not have a place. So in May 14, 1948, there was a massive return of Jewish people to the land, to their land. Who did that? It is the American-led United Nations that led that, that spearheaded that. So America, if you look at the, one thing I want to talk about that, look at the eschatology, the last empire the last empire, you know, in God's hand, that God will use before the coming of Christ. You know, a lot of studies and history, prophetic, you know, look, point to U.S., the so-called United Nations led by U.S. You know, we had other empires. We had Babylonian Empire, Persian Empire, you know, Roman Empire. Amen. Amen. And then we are now in the United Nations and the U.S. led United Nations Empire, so to say, you know. So, no matter what you are seeing, other nations trying to take over America, whatever, prophetically, America, it's the last empire before the rapture. You know, I said somebody proves otherwise, but by my study, I stand by that. Amen. And the old scriptures point to that. Most scriptures, images of scriptures, and by my own study, and I've seen people talk about it too. America is the last one. Praise God. So, that is why despite, let me just say something about it. That's why despite what's going on in America, it's as though all the attack of other nations, it's as though the country is still not shaking. Although it's been shaking just moral decadence, things going on in America, and then though other countries are fighting it to take over the supremacy of the world, you know, God's hand is still upon his nation. You know, unlike the time of one of the king of Babylon, who took the golden vessel of the temple, the day we were partying and drinking themselves to stupor. He went and he took the golden vessel of the temple that was destroyed and started making merry. You know, that day, the handwriting of God came on the wall. He said, tonight, you have been judged and weighed, and your time is over. And that same night, the Medo-Persia, the knight came and took over Babylon. That's how that's what they took over. That's why we now had the shift of Babylon to Medo-Persia Empire. That's the night. God's hand was on it. Not because the people of Israel sinned, and God said to allow them to take you into captivity as a way of kind of teach them a lesson, does not mean you should desecrate the temple. So when the king did that, God said, the handwriting of God was there. He said, look, your end has come. That's how Babylon ended. So Persia Empire took over. That's the night. Praise God. So, the people think the same history might be repeated in America. That okay, the same way, maybe God's hand is against America, other nation come and take over the way, you know. The devil is very funny. He's trying to repeat the same history. No. That's why I strongly believe that I'm telling you very strategic. I'm trying to take my time to talk about this. One thing that is very strategic, because people might think that some other nations, they're trying to take over America, American time is over. Other countries are to go to America, and then after then, God will not begin. No, this is the last phase. He said somebody puts otherwise to me this last empire that God will use before rapture. So we're not going to have like a Chinese empire or have whatever empire or Russian empire. To my own study, my best of knowledge, he said someone puts it otherwise. Praise God. So he's going to be the last one. And if you look at the golden image of, anyway, I don't want to go to God, so time will take my time. That's eschatology. You know, maybe one day I'll find out, we're going to look at the golden image of Nebuchadnezzar, what it represents, all those parts. So that's where I got my revelation about that, that America is the last one. Despite the moral decadence and problems in America, people preaching against certain things and all these moral things we are seeing, lesbianism, homosexualism, all this we are seeing causing decadence in America. All those things you are seeing, corruptions here and there, troubles everywhere. Despite the shakings, God's hand is still upon America. Amen. That's the truth. Because America is very strategic in terms of where God is going. Take for instance, if God decides to shift its empire to some other nations, praise God, the war would not be the way it is today. America is the one holding so many things. From so many things happening, not happening. Praise God. I'm trying to be careful that I'm on camera. Not happening. Praise God. So if God's hand leaves America, if we go have studied other nations and see which other nation can also be able to handle these things I want to do before the second return of Jesus Christ. I mean, to me, from my own study, I've not seen that nation qualify for this, to do this. America is a Christian nation, first of all. Even though some people are trying to make it to, cause some problem here and there, it's still a Christian nation. Its roots, its foundation is a Christian. Even though they have open policy where other religion is trying to do certain things. But that's still a strong base Christian foundation. For about that, I mean, they're not really doing what they're supposed to do, but then they still have Christian value. So they stand strategically to one other places. And then other nations who are trying to marginalize Christianity, they, because of America, they are afraid. Am I communicating?
Yes.
Some of them are scared. You know, especially when you have someone who actually believes in the Christian value. I'm not being partisan. So we believe in Christian value, you know, and other nations are trying to make sure they suppress certain things so they can come and run over some things, you know. But the leaders, if you have the leaders of the nation are Christian to the core, you know, and they believe in Christian values. Even though, as I said before, there are some moral decadence going on, like abortion, this and that, you know, church being taken out of certain things. You know, it's still, America is still the hand of God for the time we're in, the rapture comes in. No matter what's going on. That's the truth. Please, let nobody deceive you. Because I've seen people preaching this thing. It's good to stabilize us. People preaching this thing and saying that November, China will run over America and something will happen. That is, it's not scripturally true. Somebody had a dream and was talking about something like that. I listened to it. And I was asking myself, prove it in the scriptures. Show me where it is in the Bible. I mean, anybody can dream any dream. Praise God. You know, so let's be careful when we list all these things. Because things are happening in America does not mean God has left America. The foundation of this country is God. Our founding fathers built upon, we say, in God whom we trust. Of course, we have other people who try to mess up that, Freemasonaries and other people, cultists, who are trying to do certain things to subvert the will of God over this country. Of course, because God is trying to support this country, you still keep it. There are remnants of God in this country, remnants. Who, when you go look at them, you will still keep the nation. God said, you want to stabilize them. Even though, because America, Israel will have some problem. So America is a strong backbone of Israel. Because of Israel, God is keeping America too. Because he's supporting Israel so much. You know, and the way God works, he has used the military powers and the superpower ability of America to be able to stabilize other nations. No, if not, some other people would have run them down. So because of fear of America, some of them are being careful. They are watching before they take their step. So having said that, you know, 9/11 is very strategic. I'll tell you why it's very strategic. Very, very strategic. You know, it's September 11. I'll tell you very soon. So we need to pray for America. I'm telling you, America is still in the very center of God's plan for the world. And it's the last empire, I repeat, it's the last empire before the second coming of Christ. When the church raptures. Of course, when the church raptures, there'll be great tribulation. Then the lawless man will now be revealed fully to do his job. So then the church will have come. By then, I'm done preaching. I've left my preaching. I resign. When I continue. Anybody interested? Please, but doesn't come and take my microphone. Anybody that tells you again that will be great tribulation before rapture is a lie. It's a pure lie. There are people saying things like that, you know. I don't know why people are not reading the Bible. It's not. There are 7 years. The first 3.5 years will be like tribulations. Like tribulations. Even now we're having tribulations everywhere. Tell me when the church is not facing tribulation. It's every time tribulation. Who are using the tribulation? Oh, the world is coming down there. The Antichrist is. No. The church is not gone yet. The church is still holding it. Only the power of the full manifestation of the lawless man. The church is still in charge. How dare you come and run over the church? It's not possible. Even though you persecute the church and cause tribulation, the church is still standing. So, but if the church is taken out, then there will be great tribulation. Even when the church is taken out, there will be 3.5 years of kind of things, you know, that kind of things going on. This post rapture preachers, we see the preaching, not knowing that the church has gone. Praise God. the first 3.5 years, let us come and say, peace, peace, let it be peace, everybody, peace. All of a sudden, I'm studying destruction. The Bible says it. Because then the next 3.5 years, which make it 7 years, would be terrible. Very terrible. Very, very terrible. That's what you see the internet on now. It's giving. Lawless man using it to announce his arrival.
Yes.
On the internet. Internet TV. That's how you're gonna announce it. And people will be glued, because there will be so much catastrophe. Rapture will be taking place. Plane will scatter. The vehicle will fall. People, no, those who are gonna go and driving, that will be, no, they drop the vehicle, will enter bush. The plane will, no, will crash. There'll be so much chaos in the world. When the rapture comes in, then the first 3.5 years, the world will be off balance. Then the lawless man will have, okay, you know what, I can solve the problem, I can do this, I can do that. He will begin to stabilize some things. People will not believe in him. After they will announce his arrival. Then the last 3.5 years, they will strike. To be terrible. But then we'll be up there looking over them.
Yes, sir.
Yeah, sorry. I told you all to be one to get reviews. I told you all. I can't see Jerry. Yeah. They will be saying it everywhere they go. Is that I'll be hearing preaching all this one that refuse to repent. Had I known. The blood of Adam knows when that Adam knows so much everywhere.
Yeah.
But guess what? Some people so courageous, they will decide to be courageous. Say, no, we're not going to take the Antichrist, the mark of the beast. We'll still be preaching. They will try it, but eventually, at that point, it is too late. They'll be saved by their blood, of course. Don't get me wrong. They'll be saved by their blood. There will be second resurrection. Yeah. Some will be mutilated, like mutilated. They will die. They will ask for death to come. They will not come. They ask for great caves and mountains to fall on them. They will not come. So it will be very torturous. Terrible. Imagine somebody getting an iron, put inside fire, and then pass it through. I will use the golf to bring your eyes out. Slow death. And by the grace of God would have been withdrawn to greater extent because, oh God, heal my eyes. Sorry. Healing is. Oh Lord, deliver me. Sorry. It will be deliverance by the blood. Not by grace. So we are shouting now, we're born again. Yeah, I don't want to forget people. I'm sorry for you. I'm sorry for you. I'm sorry for you. Praise the Lord. And I pray for all of us. All the members of Holy Ghost Fellowship, those online, everybody who is truly and genuinely born again, may we not miss this thing. In the name of Jesus. May we stand fast. To the end, in the name of Jesus. We will receive the crown in the name of Jesus. Thank you, precious Father. Friends, I'm saying this to say because the Christianity, so to say, physically, America is the hope of Christian nations. So we want to pray for this country. Part of our prayer for this month. This country, pray for the election. It's very strategic again. That God's will be done.
Amen.
Praise God. So, you know, people travel, they have accident. Demons are sucking blood. It's time to suck blood. So this thing called global stronghold of Ebamut, we want to destroy it. We want to kill it and destroy and put instead it will affect our nations, it will affect our family, it will affect our husband, our children. That's the first one. Destruction of global stronghold of evil manifestation of the Ebamut. Number two is 9/11 strategic move of God upon America.
9/11.
That is 9/11. No. America is very strategic, you know. So because of that, what happened 9/11, I'll tell you why. I'm going to come back to it later. I want to give you some things. So hold that place, but I'll just explain to you about what God is doing concerning America, the agenda of America, you know, God has for America. America is the last, you know, is the hope of many Christian nations, and is the last empire before the rapture, church rapture. That's the truth. Okay, so number three now, as you said, the cycle of life, which is called the 9-month cycle of life, when there will be a new beginning, delivery. You know, children are born when they're 9 months in the womb. So there is this new beginning, new life. Life comes, new life comes in. New beginning comes in. So it's a mode of delivery. Which means that whatever thing that will be carrying your wombs in January to now, at these 3 days of fasting and prayer, you will deliver it.
Yeah.
All the visions, all the prayer we're making, all the believing God and trusting God, you are being all this while. This is your month of delivery.
Yeah.
As we end up this year, I'm going to tell you why towards the end of September is very strategic. I'll tell you very soon. That's what we're doing September to remember. Because towards the end of September is very strategic. Because that's when in terms of God's plan. I will tell you very soon. God's plan for his people. That's when there's delivery of God's plan for the people. That's when the major manifestation of God towards the end of September. So I believe God, within these 3 days of fast and prayer, that everything you believe God for in your life, trusting the Lord, you shall see results. You shall profit from God's word. There will be restoration and deliverance in the mighty name of Jesus. This is your turn. This is your turn. It's your turn. For we serve the true and living God, who the same yesterday, the same today, the same forevermore. If God has done it for them, it's your turn. I say it's your turn. I say it's your turn. Shout, it's my turn. In the name of Jesus. It's number four. Number four. Okay, I'm going to give you some historic and prophetic reason why September is very important. And I'm going to tell you other times. So, in the Jewish lunar month, because Jewish people use lunar months. Okay, listen very carefully. They use lunar months. We use the so-called Orthodox months to calculate our time. They use lunar months based on the moon, how the moon appears. And I told you, moon and sun, all these things determine seasons and times. Remember, we looked at that already. Time, seasons, and times. So, Jewish people use lunar to determine their days. No. So, first of all, let me say this. The first time in the book of Ezra, let me skip away a scripture. Book of Ezra, I'll read Ezra 3. Thank you, Lord Jesus. Godly Brahma Shokoto. Thank you, Lord Jesus. Okay, let me just read one verse, just to explain one. Ezra chapter 3, verse 6. From the first day of the seventh month began they to offer burnt offering, unto the Lord, but the foundation of the temple of the Lord was not yet laid. Okay, let me prepare, I want to show you some things now. You see, the way Israel calculate their months is different from the way Orthodox do theirs. Okay? I'm going to show you something now very quickly. See, that's what they call in Israel. You know, this thing was very difficult to pronounce. What they call Rosh Hashanah. Rosh Hashanah is being celebrated in September. Every year in September. Mostly September, October, mostly in September. Towards the end of September. You know, that's when they celebrate it. So, and it means the head of the year. Rosh Hashanah means the head of the year in Hebrew. And usually celebrated in September. That's why when we look at the beginning of life, when children are born, that begins their own life. So it's prophetically aligning to this very thing Jewish people are doing. You know, the Jewish calendar. Because that's the head of the year. That's the beginning of the year. That's the beginning of all things. Because that's when life begins. When children are born to this world. Now, if all that goes away to say that, it's believed that that day that God created Adam and Eve in September. I'm reading from history. I went through history. That God created Adam and Eve in September. You know. And then they used that day as a way to celebrate creation. So creation is being celebrated in most of September. Okay. Now, after the return from exile, the first return of exile, so they made sacrifice. You know, because the temple was not yet built, the altar was not yet constructed, so they had to go and use the former place where they had the old altar. They had to reconstruct and rebuild the altar, first of all, to sacrifice to their God. And that happened in September. That's what you see in verse 6 says, from the first day of the seventh month. So, in the Jewish calendar, the seventh month is the month of September. It has to do with September. So, but then, prophetically, it has to do with the head of the month, head of the year. Am I going to get it? Yes. So, orthodoxically, refers to the seventh month, but in Jewish calendar, refers to the month of September, which is the head of the year. Am I going to get it?
Yes.
Sometimes when you see Bible, it's written in quote many translation from Greek to English, English to Latin, different kinds of things. So sometimes you look at the Bible, it's not, if you look at the original Hebrew, you're going to get a proper, you know, description of all these things. You look at NIV, you go to a Living Translation, you're going to see that. Who has Living Translation? Living Translation says it is in September, in the month of September. That's like, so that scripture says, I checked that scripture, it says, the seventh month. But if you look at Levi translation, it tells you month of September. That's verse 6. So, having said that, you can see it's very important for us to remember September, because September is the time, beginning of a life. Two, September is the head of the month. That's a good Jew. Since Jewish people, Israel is the point of contact for, it's a political country. The Jewish people that God have chosen by himself, but it's also a form of the church. So, we look at how God dealt with Israel as a way to our spiritual reformation. Am I communicating?
Yes.
Prophetically. So we look at what's going on in Israel. Prophetically, it's also what's going on in among the Christians or the Christianity. So prophetically, so we are saying that September is good to remember because it's the head of the year. So in the realm of the spirit, September is the beginning of the year. Am I communicating?
Yes, sir.
Two, September in Orthodox is ninth month where children are born. So life begins. So we go through that too. If you go by that, then September is beginning of life. So it's good to remember September. And prophetically, the devil, Satan himself, decided to deal with the nation that God is trying to use to stabilize Christian nations and promote his agenda and use them as the last empire of the year. That is the same one devil decided to attack. America. Am I going to get it?
Yes, sir.
Devil decided to attack America the same month of September. And that same month of September is when Jewish people returned and they made sacrifice. They built the altar. They rebuilt the altar. You know, they were taken into captivity for 70 years. When they came back, that was the month they started. They rebuilt the temple, the altar, and made the first sacrifice after 70 years. The month of September. And precisely they say about 20th of September, towards the end of September. Am I going to get it? So, prophetically speaking, from all this, and that's the time it's been believed that was created, the month of September was made. And then that time, they said they're about to celebrate creation. That time, the altar was rebuilt, and then sacrifice was made to God, because over 70 years, they did not make sacrifices. Except the shedding of blood, that's the remission of sin. So, there was no shedding of blood for 70 years. Can you imagine that? But so when they came back, on precisely 20th of September, they now began to rebuild the altar and make sacrifices. And they were so, but from that time onwards, they had to do sacrifice in the morning, evening, as they used to do before. They were full of joy. They returned back to what God has asked them to do. Amen. So, having said this, you can see that September is very strategic and very, very important month to remember. Number four?
The month the altar was rebuilt.
Rebuilt when after the return from Ezra. Which was rebuilt and the first sacrifice was made after 70 years. And then it's also the head of the year. September is head of the year. You know, in the Orthodox calendar, as I said, it's the other way around, but to them, it's the beginning of the year. And then, as I said before, you go to the illustration in Ezra chapter 3, verse 6, it says in the month of September, the first day of the month of September. Amen. Well, some shall say first day, some say 20th. Praise the Lord. So all this is something, you know, scripture sometimes is not some of the words they use. Praise the Lord. Let's just say, from the first day of the seventh month began they to offer burnt sacrifices unto the Lord. Amen. The first day of the month. Now, some history say on the 20th. Some say first. Let us go by what we say on the first. However, it all tells us that September is very, very strategic in the prophetic calendar of God to be remembered. Am I communicating?
Yes, sir. So what is number four?
We are in operation, eh?
Which one is number four?
That's what you're asking.
Return from exile, and they do their first sacrifice in the month of September.
So all is one.
That's all the four, for you. That's the fourth one, lunar month, Jewish lunar month. You know, September is the beginning of their year. And then that's when September was when they offered the first sacrifice after the return from Ezra 70 years. So that's one of the things. So having said that, you can see that's why the same devil attacked America in the month of September. That's a very important. That was the year of sacrifice, restitution of sacrifice, the shedding of the blood, which is the central focus of Christian, you know, religion. In terms of Jewish, amen. So, you see, devil knows these things. You know, so he tried to be strategic in his dealings. He's also strategic in his dealings. Just as God is so strategic. You know, Lucifer was actually, in the truth part of it, Lucifer was not trying to overthrow God per se. But Lucifer wanted to have parallel truth with God. Get my point? He wanted to do a parallel truth. Okay, they serve you, people should have choice. Charge you or serve me. A parallel truth. You know, so the same thing it does. So when there's a prophetic move of God, concerning an area, Lucifer was supposed to imitate it and counteract it. So since America was a center, you know, a nation that God has put his hand upon to use a strategic nation to handle other things, so that same mood devil struck. So that's why we need to pray for America. That same devil that struck will not come back again to strike this nation. But whether they like it or not, America still remains the strategic agenda of God for the last move of God. For the rapture. Amen. So that's what we pray for this country. Don't join other people who are mentioning bad things and castigate America. Don't join them. Whether you like it or not, God is still in this country. His hand is upon this country. Doesn't matter what anybody does, any party does, doesn't matter. I'm not partisan, doesn't matter. So all I know is that once God has chosen this country and placed his hand on top of it, nobody can stop it. No matter what they do, God will turn it around for his own good. Hallelujah, hallelujah. So having put these four things together, it's therefore very, very strategic that we need to remember September, because it's a window. Number one, say I told you it's a portal. It's a portal, you know, for the rest of the month, because this Embermont thing is going to be a global stronghold. People are scared of Embermont. That's the time the devil actually come to suck blood to this Embermont. People travel and they accident everywhere. So we need to pregate it, number one. Number two, devil knows that September is a strategic month in God's calendar, God's agenda. That's the month that Israelites came back to restitute altar and made his first sacrifice to God after 70 years. So, and devil knows that America has, God used America as a strategic point of his agenda. So he struck in the month of September. So September is very strategic. Number three, I say it's cycle of life. You know, life is being, women get pregnant in the ninth month, according to Orthodox counting. In the ninth month, the baby comes out of the womb. So that's the beginning of life for the baby. Praise God. So based on that, everything that God has done in our life, we are trusting God for, every vision we are carrying in our womb, we are pregnant for these years, all this time, beginning of the year, now it's time for us to deliver. Am I communicating?
Yes.
Am I communicating?
Yes.
So, and I said again, number four is, that is very strategic, because September is the time that they returned and rebuilt the altar and they made the first sacrifice, because without shedding of blood, there is no remission of sin. And they've not shed their blood to an animal for 70 years. It's very strategic. So it was done in month of September. Praise God. So that's four, right? You got it?
Yes, sir.
Okay. So let's now look at some things again very quickly. Oh, thank you, Jesus. Thank you, Jesus. Amen. I have some history to tell you about the month of Nisan between March and April. April to May. These are just, don't need it. It's the month of Sivan between May and June. The month of Tammuz, June and July, July and August, Elul, August and September, then Tishri, September and October, Shavuot, October and November, Kisvel, November and December, Tevet, December and January, Shavuot, January and February, so on and so forth. You don't need all that. Amen. No, man, I go to something, I have to look into this, because, you know, if you are a preacher, you need to know these things to come off. You don't have to preach it per se, but good to have knowledge of them. Praise God. Amen. He helps to stabilize you. Nobody can just come and tell you things anyhow. You have studied. The Bible says, study yourself to show yourself approved. Amen. Amen. Thank you, Lord Jesus.
Thank you.
Thank you, Father. Thank you, Father. Let's pray one prayer first of all. Every spirit of Embermont, Ye Pragato Shaba, Embermont, name of Jesus. We declare. You have no hold over us. Every stronghold of Eba Mota, we destroy you. She prakato sakata, mali prakato shekete, li prakato sakata lava, ali prekete, papa lokodu, e sakata li prekete, e shali prekata sakato, ashoko to li prekata, mayato lo prakato sekete, e li prakato shakata la bragade, e li prakato sakata, mali prakato sekete, e li prakato sakata la bragade, e ye papa lokodu sekete, mala prakato shekete, ye prakato sakata li prekete, e ye papa lokodu, use of amber moons. Name of Jesus, I secure my September, I secure my October, I secure my November, I secure my December. No weapon for me against me shall prosper. No against my husband shall prosper. No against my wife shall prosper. No against my younger ones and him shall prosper. No against my children shall prosper. No against my loved ones shall prosper. I secure this ember motor. I secure it by the blood of the lamb. By the blood of the lamb. By the blood of the lamb. It's a kotoli brekete. It's a la bragado sekete. In bragado shakata. Aye brek. Le bragado, et sa palacade, et chakila bragade, maso koto li bragada, mayandolo bragado, et sa katoli brigade, et le bragado sakata, mayandolo bragado, et kali bragado sekete, et le bragado sakata li brigade, ayandolo babalogudo, et le bragado sakata, ali bragado sakaba, emba mota, atekotoj over you, a mot of September, mot of October, mot of November, mot of December, atekotoj over you, in the name of Jesus Christ of Nazareth. You will not do me any harm. You are my cataba. Do me good. I command you to me good. I command you to me good. I command you to me good. In Salibra Gada Lagada Lagada Lagada. I will not die. My wife will not die. My husband will not die. My children will not die. My loved ones will not die. Holy Ghost fellowship members will not die. We shall live to declare the words of the Lord. Ali Bragada Lagaba Lagada. Ele Bragado. I come against the powers of Eba Mota. The strong force of Eba Mota. All sucking demons, all blood sucking demons, Ali Bragada, the spirit of accident, Ali Bragada, I come against you, your powers, you demon sucking blood, your blood sucking demons, your witchcraft manipulation, working against the ember motor, I subdue you, I curse you from your root, I curse you from your root, Ali Bragada Lagada Laba, Ele Bragado Sokoto Libregade, Ele Bragada Lababa Lagade, Ele Bragada Labragado Lobobo, Ele Baba Lagada, every stronghold of Eba Mota, I curse you from your root. I curse you from your root. I curse you from your root. In the name of the Lord. In the name of the Lord. In Sakata la Bragade. Ele Bragado Shakata. Ele Bragado Shekete. Ele Bragado Sakata. Mayandolo Bragado. Ele Bragado Sakata Librekete. Ele Bragado Sakata Librekete. Ayandolo Bragado Sekete. Ayanda Librekete. Ayanda Librekete. Papa Lokoto. E Sali Brigete. Papa Lagade. E Yabrogodo. Ele Bragado Sakata. Mayanda Librekete Papa Lagade, Ezali Brekete, Eye Baba Lokoto. I pull down the global stronghold of Eba Mota. I pull down the global stronghold of Eba Mota. I curse from your root. I curse you from your root. By the power of the Holy Ghost, Ele Bragada Lagada Lagada, Ele Bragada Baba Lagada, I shall not die. I shall not want to kill me. Nobody can kill me. I am undiable. I pull control Baba. I am Baba Laba. I am undiable. I am unkillable. No one can kill me. No one can kill me. No one can kill my husband. No one can kill my wife. No one can kill my children. We are undiable. We are unkillable. Oh, month of September. Oh, the ember month. I destroy global strongholds of sucking demons. I destroy your plans. I destroy your works. I pull you down. 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 Powers of darkness, I bring you down. I bring you down. Use blood sucking demons, I destroy you. 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 Ele bragada lagada lagada. Ele bragada lagada lagada. Ele bragada lagada lagada. Ele bragada lagada lagada. Ele bragada lagada. Masokoto. Le bragada la baba, ele bragado lo baba, e sali brigade papa lagade, ele bragado lo baba, e sakato li brigade, mayanda le bragado, e sala bragado lo baba, ele bragado le bebe, ele baba le gede bebe, ele bragada la baba lo godo, ele bragado lo baba lo godo, ele bragado lo baba, masokoto li brigade, ele baba lo godo, ele mama lagado, ele baba lagado sekete, ele mama lukete, mayanda li brigade papa lo godo, ele mama lukete baba lagade, e bali gede papa lo godo. de salu brigado secrete de ye baba logodo secrete mayanda li brigete baba logodo ele makute le bragada mayando lo brigado secrete de ye mama logodo secrete de ye baba logodo legede mayanda la baba logodo ele bragado lo bobo logodo ele makata li brigete e shakata li brigete baba lagade de ye mama logodo secrete de ye baba logodo sakata mayando lo brigado secrete de ye baba lagada sakata mayando lo bobo logodo ele baba lagada poche secrete. Zobrakata Zebrakato Zabrakato Librikete. Oh, Mali Brakatash Zebrakato Sapai Zebrakata. In the name of Jesus. Number two, let's pray for America. I want to pray for this prayer, man. Don't just begin to talk at them before about it. And I will pray about it, then it's time I continue. You know, so we can stop there. Let me pray for America. Let me tell us something. Even though, let's read something. Take your Bible to Ezra. It's in Ezra. Ah, thank you, Lord Jesus. Ezra chapter 3, the same chapter 3 we just read now. Verse 7. Are you there?
Yes.
They gave money also unto Mason, unto carpenters, unto meat. Meat, drink, oil, unto them of cedar, and to them of Tyre, to bring cedar trees from Lebanon, to seas of Joppa, according to the grant that they had from Cyrus, king of Persia. Friends, do you know that in Isaiah chapter 40, I think 44, 45, Isaiah prophesied about Cyrus, king of Persia, 150 years before he was born. That God will use Cyrus. Bible says, Cyrus, my anointed servant, will be used to deliver Israel from captivity.
Yeah.
Can you imagine that? Before even Cyrus was born. Praise God. Look at it here. Now, and it actually did happen.
Yeah.
Cyrus was the one that asked them to leave. To go and rebuild that temple and pray to that God.
Yeah.
He said, pray for me too. He said, pray for me also.
Yeah.
So he gave them money. Asked them to go. Thank God for how Cyrus Persia destroyed, took over everything from Babylon, and then, this God is too much.
So
prophecy, you see, that's what I believe. No matter what devil is doing, everything God has said about you must come to pass.
Amen.
I'm telling you, it doesn't matter what devil is doing, it must come to pass.
Amen.
some people are even saying, because Ezra wrote Ezra. Ezra was a scribe, also a priest. Amen. He wrote Ezra. Somebody will say that maybe he saw a book of Ezra, or he saw Isaiah, that it was going to be used. Some people are saying that they're going to be used. Maybe he saw Isaiah prophecy that Cyrus will be used. That's why now he asked them to go. Well, whatever be the case, whether he saw it, doesn't see it, all I know is that prophecy fulfilled.
Yes.
God's word came to pass.
Yes.
He said, my word will not go and come back to me void.
Yes.
Imagine 150 years of prophecy came to pass. God used it. Cyrus didn't even know where God was in, but God called him anointed servant.
Yes.
Meanwhile, he was a heathen.
Yes.
So God can use anybody. That's why you know in a land of America, it does not matter who is there as long as it's being used of God. Anybody can be Cyrus on the throne in America. Anybody can be Cyrus to liberate people of God, to liberate Christian nations, to stabilize Christianity in the world. Anybody can be used. Oh God, help America. September to remember. Yes, devil death to America 9/11. We are coming back against him in the same September. Hallelujah. Devil will come against you. Every plan you have against America, we destroy your plan. We destroy your plan. We destroy your plan. Yes, this is a nation God wants to use. Anybody without born again, noble again, can be used as King Cyrus to deliver nations. To deliver nations. To deliver nations. Alibrakada lakada. Alibrakada lakada 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 lakada. America. Help America. The name of Jesus. Friends, I was going through the history and I discovered that Ezra means God my helper.
Yes.
God, my helper. But God used Cyrus to help him. Am I communicating?
Yes,
so, this is what God used America to help Christians.
Yes,
to liberate people. People from poverty. People from, you see, God used Cyrus to even restore them back financially.
Yes.
Israel have no money. They have no money to go come back. But he gave them money.
Yes,
sir. God used him. The man, I'm very sure the man knew what he was doing.
Mm-hmm.
But, oh my God. Let's pray this prayer first. Oh God, use America to stabilize Christian nations, to stabilize Christian nations, to destroy the kingdom of darkness, to pull down nations who are against Christian nations by fire, by fire, by fire, by fire, by fire, by fire. Oh, pull your mouth and fire prayer. Every plan of the devil against America's nation, we pull you down, 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 we pull you down. We decree and declare, America is anointed servant of God. America is anointed servant of God. America is anointed servant of God. That in days of King Cyrus, America is anointed. Nobody can stop him. Nobody can stop him. Nobody can stop him. Nobody can stop him. Nobody can stop America. We declare, as I am a Kababa, we declare in the name of Jesus, America is strong. America is healthy. America is strong. America is strong. No one can stop it. No one can stop it. No witch can stop it. In the name of the Lord Jesus. Oh, America, we bless you. America, we bless you. America, we bless you. We call you blessed. We call you blessed. We call you blessed. We call America blessed. Hey, Zubrakada, break it up, man so good, lay brakada, see brakada, lay brakada, heli brakada, mali brakada, heli 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 brakada, Zukata la brakada, heli brakada, baya brakada, heli brakada. Oh, bless America. Be to bless America. Bless it, bless it, bless it. Ah, America will call you blessed. We'll call you blessed. Oh, bless America. Your children will grow in this country. Ah, and they'll become somebody in this country. Ah, we bless this country. The country has given us opportunity. The country that gave us opportunity. The country that gave us help. We not walk. We not walk. We not walk. We not walk. Ah, shala brakada lakada lakada. Ele brakada lakada lakada. Ele brakada lakada lakada. Ele brakada lakada lakada. Ele brakada lakada lakada. The plan of the devil will not work. The name of Jesus, we frustrate them. We frustrate the plans. We frustrate the plans. We frustrate the plans. We frustrate the plans. Oh Lord Jesus, Maso Kata, Libra Koto, Zebra Kata, we frustrate the plans of the devil against America. We frustrate it, we frustrate it, we frustrate it, we frustrate it. Maso Pali Palakada, Zubra Kata, Makoto Libra Kata, Yamaba.
Yes, Lord,
in the name of Jesus. Friends, you know, the devil is very wicked though.
Yes.
When they return back to start to try to build, you know, as Israel, you see in verse 7, how we're trying to give money to carpenters, do this. Some of the people in that country who were not proper Jews, they rose up against them. Again, there was a problem. As a matter of fact, the nation, they couldn't build a temple for the next 14 years. Some say 14 to 16 years. Cannot be a temple. They were just there waiting. Ah, hallelujah.
Amen.
Oh, my la baba. They could not be with the enemies within. You see, enemies within are even some of those outside.
Mm-hmm.
Enemies within.
Yeah. So,
if America is strong and together, we are together, I'm telling you, no matter what other nations, they can't penetrate.
Yes. Mm-hmm.
I want to pray for togetherness.
Amen.
For strong front of America.
Amen.
You see, no matter what they do, we did the crucifix, because they now went and reported to King of Persia, but then King Cyrus was dead already. No, after then, you heard about second and third king. That was King Darius. Another king again. They went to report, said, look, this nation, you are allowed to come here. If you allow them, they will not be able to come strong. They will not pay tribute to you. So, one of the king after King Cyrus, no, now listen to them, and then they couldn't build again for the next 14 years, to 16 years. When the next king came again, the king began to look at the records. Shout the book of remembrance.
Book of remembrance.
Began to look at the records and say, was it really true that King Cyrus gave him permission to leave the land to go and build a place?
Okay.
That's called that King Cyrus actually said that. And he himself won't give them money. And I said, you know what? Leave it alone. Let them go and build.
Yeah.
Ah, yeah, baba. It's called the Book of Remembrance.
Yeah.
Ah, yeah, that when things are written about you, written down, kings upon kings will come and look at it.
Amen.
Even though something to Mordecai, what he did to the king.
Yes.
He said, this man that didn't go to the king, has he been blessed at all?
Yeah.
It was a time when Haman was trying to destroy the Jews.
Yeah.
It happened at that same period.
Yes.
And the king began to look at the records.
Mm-hmm.
And so that this man was not honored.
Yeah.
He now called the alien and said, what do you think should be done to whom the king delights to honor? Supreme Haman thought it was for him. He said, yes, king. The person that the king decided like to honor, should put on him the golden apparel. put him on the bus, on the horseback. And let everybody shout, oh, look at whom the king had decided to honor. Prophetically, King Haman, sorry, Haman was a hangman.
Yes, sir.
I call him hangman, son of Haman.
Yes.
He was Satan himself.
Yes, sir.
Against Jewish, against Christians.
Yes,
no, we're Haman everywhere in the world. Fighting like America. Fighting Israel in America. So many Hamans.
Yes, sir.
Satanic manipulation. Okay, you know what? You know what touched me? When the king asked him, no, the first time was, hey, man, how long back? Oh, my God. Oh, my, this God is wonderful.
Yeah.
This God is wonderful. The king did not ask Haman, what do you think I should do to Mordecai? Whom the king decided to honor. He said, what do you think should be done to whom the king had the right to be honored?
Mm-hmm.
He didn't mention Mordecai.
Yes.
If you have mentioned Mordecai, I would say, no, kill him.
He
had planned to annihilate Jewish people.
Mm-hmm.
He said, what do you think should be done to a man whom the king had decided to honor? So to delight to honor. He said, do this. Haman thought he was the one. He was ready. He was already ready for battle.
That's
what
my enemy was.
Oh my God! And I said, okay, just what you have done, said exactly, do it to Mordecai. Hey! He said, what is this? What did I get myself into? That's why I call him Haman the Hangman. That's his last name, Haman the Hangman. That's all those strong men trying to do evil. They will go with hand all of them. In fact, what they plan, but they said they cannot. They plan to. They will enter it.
They will kill themselves.
As I told us, evil shall slay the wicked.
Yeah.
It's not even going to be. They said that is the plan. They will hang themselves into it.
Yeah.
The gallant Haman plan. He hang himself in it.
Yeah.
Every plan of the devil against America. Yeah. Receive fire. Receive fire. Receive fire. Receive fire. Receive fire. 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 Remember this.
By fire. Open the book of remembrance. And remember me. Remember me. In the month of September. Oh, praise God, remember. The month of September. Oh, Lord, remember me. Oh, Lord, remember my husband. Remember my wife. Remember my children. Remember the immigration people. Remember my wife. Remember my children. Remember Holy Ghost family. Remember those online. Remember us. Open the book of history. The book of people. The book of remembrance. Remember the old God. In your book of remembrance. In your book of remembrance. In your book of remembrance. Oh God, remember me. Oh God, remember me. Oh God, remember me. Ayakada, lakada, lakada. Elibakada, lakada. Elibakada, lakada, lakada.
Said about you, no devil can stop it. Everything that I said about America, nobody can stop it. Nobody said that. You know that the return of Israelites were in three phases, not just one time. The first phase was only the leadership of Zerubbabel. Amen. The man called Zerubbabel. Yeah, and Joshua. Amen. Yes, Zerubbabel and Joshua. If you look at the same Exodus chapter 3, verse 8, that was a man called Zerubbabel and Joshua. That was the first return. It was about 50 something thousand left there. Then after some years, Ezra the priest, also the scribe, also returned with some Jewish people again. Then the final was in Nehemiah. They turned three faces. And King of Persia were the one giving them passage to go. And each one had returned with money. So what am I saying? Whatever God has said concerning you, no devil can stop it.
Amen.
Everything God has said concerning America, no devil can stop it.
Amen.
It does not matter the attack. They were attacked.
Yes, Lord.
But guess what? Oh my God. They still became victorious at the end of the day.
Amen.
Am I communicating?
Yes, Lord.
Every plan of the devil against America. Every plan of the devil against my life. In the name of Jesus. What is written is written, oh, in the name of Jesus, I declare, your plan will not prosper, your plan will not prosper, your plan will not prosper. Oh, pour your altar fire prayer. Zalakada, lakada, lakada, lebrakada, 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 lakada, lakada. Your plan will not prosper. Your plan will not prosper. Your plan will not prosper. My lebrakade, lebrakado, my zokodo, lebrakada, my yandolo, lebrakade, lebrakade, lebrakade. Hey, Baba Lagade, Mayandala Baba, hey, Baba Lugudu, is Ali Brigade, 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 is Eye baba baba, eye baba baba, eye baba baba, eye baba baba, mala pragado, isala baba, eye baba. Every plan of the devil, I say to no walk, I say to no walk, I say to no walk, I say to no walk. Isala baba baba lagade, eye pragado sakata, mayando lo pragado,
ele bagado lo babo esa katali bigede mayanga lo babo ele bagado sekete mayanga lo bagade ele babalo godo eye babalo gado maso kontoli baba mayanga lo babo ele bagado baba eye baba baba aya baba baba eye 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 baba baba aya 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 baba baba bala baba baba ele baba baba bala baba baba bala baba lugudu ele baba baba bala baba lugudu ele baba lagada ele baba lagada aya baba baba ele baba baba bala brigade baba lugudu ele sala baba lugudu ele baba lagada bala baba baba bala baba baba bala baba baba ele baba baba ele baba baba bala baba lagada ele baba lugudu ele sala baba baba Masoliva, Zubragade, Jebrakto, Makotoli Brigade, Makotoli Brigade, Ashababa, Zubrakete, Malo Brigade, Makatoli Brigade. Ah, give me praise, I give you praise. Masoliva, in the name of Jesus. Friends, this prayer is very important. The next prayer point at the circle of life. That everything you have believed God for, trusted God for, since January, by the Orthodox calendar, 9 months is a month of delivery.
Yes.
So we want to pray, oh God, by the Jewish calendar, by the Orthodox, it doesn't matter. But right now is the 9th month, I command me, everything I've been pregnant of, it's time to deliver. It's time to deliver. It's time to deliver. Whatever vision you believe God for, whatever you trust God for, it's time for deliverance. It's time for delivery. It's time for delivery. Oh God, le bragata la baba, le bragato sekeba. Ah, yeah, baba. The ninth month is your turn. It's your turn. It's your turn. Hey, baba, baba. 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 Mala bragata, mala brigade, mala bragado, mala baba, mala sokoto, mala bragade, mala dolo baba. Bili baba laba, maya baba lugudu, mala baba lagade, maya baba laba, bili baba lagada, maya baba lagade, maya da baba lagada, maya da baba lugudu, bili baba laba, maya da baba lugudu, bili baba laba, mala baba laba, maya baba laba, maya baba baba, mala baba lagade, maya baba baba, bili baba lagade, bili baba, deliver, 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 mala bragado, ishakba, maya da baba, bili bragado sokoto, maya dolo baba, maya baba baba, maya baba baba. Maya baba maya baba maya baba lugudu maya baba lugudu mali brigade baba laya maya bragado lugudu gele bagada baba lagade gele bagada la baba mala bagada baba le bagada la baba mili bagado lugudu isala bagade isala baba isala bagado maso kutu gele bagado shikute mala bagado shikute gele bagado lugudu. Hey, in the name of Jesus, put the Bible to Isaiah 66 verse 9. To the Bible, Isaiah 66 verse 9. Oh, thank you, precious Father.
Thank you, Lord.
Ah, shalaba. Isaiah 66 verse 9. Thank you, Jesus.
Thank you, Lord.
Are you there?
Yes, sir.
Shabrakato saprakate libaba. Hayandolo brogoto seketele bragadosh. Isaiah, if you see, read it. Let me see. Isaiah 66, verse 9.
Praise the Lord.
Hallelujah.
Shall I bring to the bed and not cause to bring forth? Said the Lord. Shall I cause to bring forth and shut the womb? Said the Lord.
Did you see that? Did you hear that? Will a woman be pregnant and come to the place of labor ward or paper ward, and then the baby doesn't come out? That's an error. How can you be pregnant from January, February, March, April, May, June, pregnant of your vision, what you believe God for, what you trust God for, and you come to 9th month and you will not deliver? It's an error. It's an error. So everything you believe God for, since January to now, remember with this 7 days dry fast. You remember? And you wrote so many things. That's a vision. See, that day you wrote it, that thing you wrote was like a seed. Woman taking seed and becoming pregnant. See, that month of January, you'll be pregnant up to now. Am I complicated? You'll be pregnant of your vision, of your prayer point, you'll be pregnant. Does something have come to pass? But then, some of the major ones you believe God for is not, it has not come to pass yet. That means you are still pregnant. Am I complicated? So he's saying now, will you be pregnant and come to the place of birth without giving birth? It's a question. Salem, am I confused? Will you carry this thing and come to a place to labor what or favor what without actually delivering? And 9 months is your month of what?
Delivery.
Oh God. Ah. Oh God. Lose that place, please. Lose that place you have. I need to pray. Oh God, you promise that you will not allow a woman who is pregnant to come to the labor ward or favor ward without putting to bed. It's an error. Ah, according to your word, I have come to the place of delivery. Oh Father, the grace to deliver. The grace to deliver. The grace to deliver. The grace to see my miracles. The grace to see my healing. My deliverance, my restoration, the grace, that healing I trust you for, this is the month I receive it. That deliverance I trust you for, this is my month. That thing I believe you for, this is my month. That job I trust you for, this is my month. I've been praying about it for 9 months now. This is a month of delivery, month of delivery, month of new beginning. Ayababalakata. I've trusted you for many times. Ayaba, so break it. I'm pregnant of many things. But this is my month. This is my month of delivery. I see them coming to fruition. I see them coming to fruition. According to your word. According to your word. Masopa, Lebraka, Lebrakato, Esa Libra, Malibreke, Esa Prokoto, Ayandolo Prokoto, Esa Libreke, Malibrakata, Elebrakato, Masokoto, Elebrakado, Esa Librekete, Malibreke, Esa Libra, Antolo Proko, Masolo Prokoto, Elebrakata, Maye Prakato, Esa Librekete, Elebrakado, Ayandolo, Esa Labrakade, Esa Kute, Mayandala, Epa Librekade, Ye Prakato, Eye Prakado, Eye Prakado, Eye Prakado, Eye Prakado, Masokoto Librekade, Esa Librekete, Mayandolo Prokoto, Eye Baba Lagade, Esa Librekete, Makoto Librekete, Mala Prakado, Makoto Libaya, Malagad, Sheke Papa Lokoto, Ele Prakado Shekete, your month of delivery, your month of delivery, your month of delivery. You are in the name of Jesus. I want to read amplified version of this place. It says, shall I bring to the moment of birth? You see, 3 day dry fast is a moment of birth. Can I say it again? When you're having a concentration of prayers, seclusion, when you're going extra mile, because a pregnant woman don't just mess around. Especially those who are fully loaded to deliver. Right? You have to take it easy. That means your time has come. Have I communicated?
Yes, sir.
Yeah, they will take you gently to hospital, take you gently to labor ward, take you gently to whatever. Because you are about to deliver.
Yes.
God is saying, should I bring you to that moment of delivery? And then not cause you to bring forth? It's not possible. Will I bring to the place of dry fasting and not cause you to deliver your children? To bring back your vision? To back your vision? To back your vision? How will I do that? Say, I'm the Lord. I'm not doing that. Say the Lord. Shall I cause you to bring forth and shut your womb? Says your God. He doesn't say, rejoice in Jerusalem and be glad for her. For all who love her, rejoice with her. Joy, rejoice for joy with her. All you that mourn over her. Your mourning time is over. Your mourning time is over. Your mourning time is over. You know, all this period of within 8 months to 9 months, the woman who is pregnant is full of, they see them spitting, pa, pa, pa. Pain here, pain there. They can't sleep well. Some of them have high blood pressure. You know, things like that. Some of your mothers. You go through pain. It's like you're going to a night session, pain here and there. Some of you have been hospitalized because of what you're going through. The woman cannot wait for a time of joy, a time of joy. It is called the morning time. Those times are called the morning time. When time comes, the 9th month, when the woman will not deliver. After the baby comes out, she's happy. Ah, joy everywhere. That's what Bible says in verse 10 of that Isaiah chapter 36. She will rejoice with Jerusalem. Because now it's like a woman who is brought forth to the place of delivery. She will rejoice with him. Because they're about to deliver. Be glad for her. All who love her. You know, loved ones come around women who are delivering. Say, oh, who love her? We say, rejoice with her. Rejoice for joy with her. For all who mourn over her. Ah, 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 ah. Ah, he said that ye may not and be satisfied from her consoling peace, that ye may drink deeply and be delighted with the abundance and brightness of her glory. Amen. In other words, this is the time of her glory. Friends, the time of seclusion, the time of concentrated prayer, the time of fasting and prayer is a time of delivery.
Thank you.
The time of God is saying your morning is over. So as we encounter the three-day dry fasting, God has called the place of birth, the place of delivery. And the same God said, I will cause you to deliver. I will bring your children out of your womb. He said, rejoice, rejoice. Oh God, I will rejoice. This is my month of delivery. I will rejoice. Makota li brekete. Ah, ya baba. Ya makoto. Mati brakata. Ah, ya brakete. Oh, laughter in my mouth. Laughter in my mouth. Laughter in my mouth. Joy in my mouth. Joy in my heart. Ale brakato. Esa li brekete. Makoto li brakata. Maya dolo brakato. Esa li brakata. Maya dolo brakato. Esa kete. Ele brakato. Asha kato. Eye brakato. Esa koto. Mali brakato. Is a la bracade, Mayando lo brogado, is a libregade, Makoto liba, Ayadele bracado, is Shali brigade, Epala baba logado, Ayandala, Mali brigade, Epala kata, is a libregade, Emala baga, Ele bracado sakata, Ele baba logato, is a kata, Ele bracado, Mashekete, Ele bracado, Malabo shekata. The time of money is over. The time of money is over. The time of money is over. This is your time for delivery. Your time for delivery has come. Your time to give birth has come. I see your children coming out. I see your children coming out. I see your babies coming out. I see your babies coming out. I so prakata. I see your babies coming out. I see your babies coming out. Maso koto ze prakata mayandolo prakato esakata librigate ayandala baba makoto librigate esali brigate. I see your children coming out. I see your children coming out. No one can stop it. Ah, they tried to stop it. They could not stop them from rebuilding the temple. They could not stop them. Ale prakato. They could not stop him from rebuilding the altar. They could not stop him. Ah, they will not stop you. They cannot stop you. They can't stop America. They can't stop America. They cannot stop America. It doesn't matter what their plans are. What their plans are. They cannot stop it. They can't stop America. They can't stop you. They cannot stop you now. In the name of Jesus. Ale baba lagide. Ele bragado sakata. Aya baba logodo. E salaba. Ele bragado sakata. E baba logodo. Ele mama lagade. E sakoto librigede. Mayandala, aya mama, eye baba baba, 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 makoto liba, makoto liba, ye baba lokoto, eye baba lokoto, ze prakato, aye baba lokoto, ye baba lagada, makoto liba, ele prakato, e sakata labaya, ele baba lokoto, eye mama la baba, eye baba baba baba. Eye baba lagadi, eye baba lagadi, aya baba lagadi, eye baba baba, mayando lobo kotu, mala bragadi, mayanda baba logodu, eye baba lagadi, malo bokoto sekete, mali brekete baba, mali bragato sekete, malo bokoto sekete, ye baba lagadi, ye baba logodu, e sakata, eye baba logodu, makoto li brakata, makete li bagaya, mali brekete baba laya, eye baba baba baba, eye baba baba baba. Marco Tolibaya, in the name of Jesus. Take a Bible to Revelation chapter 20. The book of Revelation. Thank you, Lord Jesus. I give you the praise, Lord. Shabraka Toliba. Thank you, Lord Jesus. Solibraka Tosa Pragadesh. Revelation chapter 20. I'm just praying. No more time to preach. Time is up. I'm just praying. So after prayer, we'll just close. Show Braga Deja Gaba. Let's look at Revelation, the book of Revelation, chapter 20. Show Braga Deja Gada. Sabragadosha Bragadi. Oh, I thank you, Father. Suba Segedi. Mayandulo. Zebragadejagada. Verse 12. I saw the dead, small and great, standing before God, and the books were opened. Another book was opened. You see that? There are many books. Which is the book of life. And the dead were judged out of those things which were written in the books according to their works. See that? So there will be books. That's why the kings would open books of remembrance. So everything you are doing, all this fasting, prayer, fellowship, Bible you're doing, it's not on that, it's being recorded. Shababaya. He said, and I saw the dead, small and great, standing before God. Everybody together. And the books were opened. Books of what? Books of works. Books of life, books of works. The book of records of books. We have books of life, books of works, and books of remembrance. And other books, of course. There were many books. He said, and other books opened, which means there were other books, which is the book of life. So this case is a book of life. The dead were judged out of those things which were written in the books according to the works. So everything we are doing, just like Mordecai was found that he did something, you know, he favored the king. The same way, there are books of remembrance for you.
Amen.
This month of September is a month of remembrance.
Amen.
Operation to what? September to remember. So what God will do for you this month? Ah, Shababa. Zubrekete. Zubragada. You will remember. I say you will live to remember. You will live to remember. You will live to remember. I say you will live to remember it. In the name of the Lord. Zubrakata. Zubrekete. Mayo Brokoto. You will live to remember. You will live to remember them. In the name of the Lord Jesus. Makoto Ibrekete. Maya dolo brokoto ze brakata. You will live to remember that. Hashokoto ze brakata. Maya dolo brokoto mali brakata. Makoto libra jekato libra kete. Oh Lord, remember me. 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 Hayagada lagada lagada. Ede bragada la baba lokoto. Ede bragada la baba legede. E sala bragado shikete. Maya dolo brokoto. Maya dali brakete. Malo brokoto. Maya dala baba logoto, libra gada shakata libra gede, mala bragato sokoto, libra gada shakele baba ya, ali brigate papa logoto, e sala bragado sekete, maya dala bragato sekete, mali brigate papa logoto, e libra gado sakata, maya dali brigate papa lagade, e shali bragado sokoto, mali brigate papa logoto, makoto libra gede papa lagade, maya gada la bragade, mala bragado sekete, e libra gado sekete, e bragado sakata, mali brigate papa logoto. In the name of Jesus. Ah, thank you, Lord Jesus. Zubrakate le babaya. Zibrakatu sakata. Zibrakata. Makatu. Ah. Malachi chapter 3, verse 16. Amen. Malachi chapter 3 says, then they that fear the Lord speak often one to another. The Lord hearkened and heard it. And look at that. And a book of remembrance. Ah, yeah. That's Malachi 3:16. You know, we read Revelation that books were open. Books, plural, many books. Book of life. You can see book of remembrance now. Amen. Books of remembrance was written before him for them that fear the Lord. Who? For who? Them that fear the Lord. Those are people that whose names are written in the book of remembrance. Them that do what? Fear the Lord. And that thought upon his name. Them that fear the Lord and thought upon his name. Thoughts. People that think about this God, they fear him, not just fearing him,
You might say, well, I fear God. But meanwhile, you don't do his bidding. Say, they that have thoughts, that think about it, they are written in the book of remembrance. That's why I know this month of September, Operation September to Remember, God will open books.
Amen.
I said, God will open books.
Amen.
I will show you something tomorrow. Don't lay foundation. I will show you something tomorrow. God will open books.
Amen.
He will see your name there.
Amen.
That my daughter, my son, have been so faithful. She fears me. He fears me. He thinks about me. He comes to fellowship, reads the Bible. He just does fasting and prayer. He's very serious in serving me. Those things I've been doing for God, God will open books and remember you.
Amen.
This month is your month.
Amen.
It's your month of remembrance.
Amen.
It's your month of remembrance.